Friday Coyotes. I'm Riley.
And I'm Liam.
Hope you guys had a good four-day weekend.
I sure did.
Now, Coyotes, sit back and relax.
And enjoy the show.
Welcome back.
Here's a quick reminder for some upcoming events on campus.
First of all, ASP wants to thank you for buying Valentine candy grams. They'll be selling more during March on St. Patrick's Day.
Also in March, on the 2nd, it's a Dr. Seuss birthday and Read Across America. ASP will also have some fun events that day.
Thanks, ASP. Let's start out the show with some fun trivia.
Take it away.
How many did you get right, Liam?
I got all of them. What about you?
Lucky, I only got one.
Next up, we have April, who interviewed a social worker for a COVID update. Let's see what she has to say.
Hey, Coyotes. You've probably heard of Omicron because it is a big problem. I'm here to feed you some facts about it and how to stay safe. Omicron is a variant of COVID-19 that was first detected on November 11, 2021. An Omicron infection is usually less severe than an infection with prior variants, but that doesn't mean all infections will be less severe. As of December 20, 2021, Omicron had been detected in most states and countries. Omicron continues to be the dominant variant in the US. Omicron spreads easier than the original virus and the Delta variant. I interviewed a healthcare worker at UCSD Hospital that works with COVID patients. Let's see what she has to say.
Day-to-day duties have changed with Omicron. We are seeing more patients with less staff, increasing our caseload and our day-to-day work. We also have new testing where employees are required to get tested once per week. Sometimes we have employees that are asymptomatic and testing positive, causing them to be out of work for 1 to 2 weeks, and that causes us to have more work with less help. Working with patients can be hard, especially those with COVID. They're not currently permitted to have any visitors, which can be difficult for both themselves and their families. We do help patients call their family via video, Zoom, or FaceTime, but it's not the same as having in-person support. Some things you could do to help prevent yourself from getting COVID is to social distance, wear a mask, wash your hands properly and often, avoid large gatherings, and also get vaccinated if you feel comfortable doing so.
Bye, Coyotes. Remember to stay safe out there.
Make sure to keep yourself and others safe so we can slow down the spread. Anyways, any plans this weekend, Riley?
I don't think so yet, you?
I'm not sure yet.
How about a new baking recipe? Let's check out how you can make a tasty treat for your family this weekend.
Happy Friday, Coyotes. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make banana bread. Let's roll the clip. Here's what you'll need. 1.5 cups of flour, 3/4 cups of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon salt, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 2 eggs, 1/2 cup of butter, 3 red bananas, and chocolate chips. In a bowl, mix together softened butter and sugar. Next, smash your bananas and add them to your bowl. crack 2 eggs and mix. In a different bowl, add flour, baking soda, salt, and vanilla. Add the bowl with dry ingredients to the bowl with your mixture. Preheat the oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. While it's heating up, fold in the chocolate chips and apply butter or cooking spray oil into your bread loaf pan. When the oven is ready, pour the dough into your pan and slip it in the oven for an hour. Once the timer goes off, take it out, let it cool for 10 minutes, and enjoy! Have a great weekend, Coyotes. This was Selena sending it back to the anchors.
Thanks, Selena. I'll make sure to try that out.
Same. Speaking about the weekend, Liam, where did you go for the Super Bowl weekend?
I went to the SoFi Stadium in Inglewood for a meet and greet with some NFL players.
Cool, check it out.
Hey Coyotes, today I went to the Super Bowl fan experience and I saw a lot of cool stuff, so let's get right into it. Alright, so before we get into it, let's talk about some background of the NFL. The NFL has been around since 1920 with the first team being the Arizona Cardinals. Now after that little background check, let's head right into the fan experience. There were a lot of games and a ton of NFL players. I got lucky and was able to meet Shaquem Griffin and Elijah Vera Tucker. Some of the games included a 40-yard dash and a punt return. We also got to see some of the props used for last year's halftime show featuring The Weeknd. There were also a lot of pictures from NFL's top 100 pictures of all time. We got to see the leading sack leader, T.J. Watt Walker, as well as Patrick Mahomes and Josh Allen. Lastly, to end it off, we have a dance battle between a Bengals fan and a Rams fan.
That looked like a lot of fun.
It was. Well, Coyotes, this show has come to an end. Also, don't forget to subscribe to CMSTV Coyotes on YouTube and follow us on Instagram at cms.tv.
Hope you guys had a terrific weekend. Once again, I'm Riley.
And I'm Liam.
See you later.